It was extremely hard. So in the first 2 years, I got to basically, the only meal I would have would be spaghetti with pasta, passata. That would be my meal. Sometimes I would add condiments, sometimes I would add garlic, that quite rarely as well. And I remember in the third year, I decided actually to build a monument to this. So I had the palette, and I don't know if you know it, but when you open passata boxes, they are silver inside. So basically I filled, you know, like I put a lot of silver at the back of a palette, yeah. And then I had an instant coffee from Asda, you know, jar, and I hollowed it, you know, and put a light inside of it, because basically that was my only coffee. I would drink a lot of instant coffee, and you know, having the light there, basically lighting you up, you know, like getting some energy from it. So I put that at the back of the palette, and on the front of the palette, there is this image with a small boat, small paper boat with a pirate ship flag going towards an island. And then on the palette, I would pierce the animation, like four instances of a paper boat slowly sinking, you know, like slowly sinking on every wooden board of the palette. Actually, I have the painting. I still have the painting, but the palette went away, you know, I destroyed it. There were a lot of materials, because that palette used to be on my desk, so I would always draw on it. I don't know, I just liked it. And I thought I'd make something with it, and that's what I did with it. And I exhibited this in my final year show, and my final year show was called Épaves des échouages, which means shipwrecks and strandings in British, in which I collected all sorts of materials from my experience in UK, and just exhibited them as failures, or like just like, you know, impasses, you know, like places you can't really escape from.